I'm Dave Motti with Coast Airbrush TV. We're down here in Newport Beach, California to go visit my friend Rick Rietveld. We're gonna go check out some of his work today. Come on, check it out. Hey Rick, it's Dave from Coast.
Hey, here? What's up? Come on in.
All right.
What's up, man?
Hey, man, just coming down to Newport Beach to see my good friend.
How are you doing, buddy?
Yeah, how you doing? All right. Hey, this is great down here. This is my first time down here. I wish I would have come down here a long time ago. This is an amazing, amazing loft that you have here.
Yeah, it's pretty cool, huh?
I love it.
It was an old boat building, and they converted it into studios, and we've got architects in here, and all kinds of creative people. It's fun.
Yeah, this is way, way cool.
The lighting's good. I've got skylights, so it helps the lighting when I'm painting, and so yeah.
Very nice. Well, what are you working on right now?
This is a commission piece for a friend of mine. It's actually a lawyer, and he collects my work. And he had this, told me he had this vision of, he's a regular foot, so he likes perfect right barrels. So his vision was Genesis 1, which was the first day of God's creation, where he's creating the earth.
Okay.
Or the oceans. And so he wanted this perfect right barrel in this like dramatic biblical scene. So anyway, that's kind of what I came up with. I started, this is a sketch right here I did for it.
That's cool.
So, you know, I wanted like, you know, nothing is kind of symmetrical. It's
right.
All uneven. We got water flowing and like a waterfall and, you know, the water spouts in the background. And so I kind of started with a sketch, and then I scanned the sketch and colored it up on the computer to get approval. And then I just went to Canvas. I just started drawing. I didn't project it or anything and just...
Wow.
So, you know, unlike
very
my...
Very colorful, very impressive.
Thank you. So
love
this
the
is... I've been working
inside the barrel there is incredible.
Yeah, so for me, you know, God is light. So, you know, he wanted, you know, the scripture is, you know, God's image, you know, God's image is going across the face of the waters. And so I didn't really want to do anything too iconic, which would bring it into more of a... I don't know what the word is, you know, more of a...
I think I know where you're going.
You know, like just too predictable.
Right.
You know, so for me, I wanted to have the light, you know, be God.
There's a lot
so,
of chaos this, going on in there.
Yeah. I don't like to get too stagnant on one, you know, one kind of technique.
Right.
Or, so anyway, this piece is, it's kind of a Dave Hockney-inspired piece, but I wanted to put my little twist on it, so I wanted to make it into a... you know, like a wave pool,
right.
Which isn't so unusual these days, but the trick on this one is I'm going to do a natural reef, coral
oh, wow.
reef with tropical fish. So you'll see through, you know, you can see through the bottom of the pool, so you'll see a tropical reef here. And so this is another commission piece for another collector.
Yeah,
so,
just a crazy perspective on
yeah.
that. I can see how that's going to be a pretty incredible piece. That's
yeah,
awesome.
Yeah, it'll be fun. So, you know, this one I'm using a lot of airbrush, but I also, you know, like to use my own hand brush. You know, I like it to have the combination of hard edges
right.
and soft. And
that's always something I try to emphasize with a lot of our customers at Coast is
mm-hmm.
that, you know, hey guys, airbrush is just a tool.
That's right.
You know, you don't even have to use it a lot to
that's
make
right.
it very impactful, and
that's
it
right.
is just a tool. And,
right.
You know, the layering that I've seen over the years, especially on canvas, where a lot of our customers have done like oil washes over the top
mm-hmm.
of acrylics,
mm-hmm.
where they'll actually seal the acrylic and do an airbrush painting, and
sure.
then, you know, use a lot of hard line, you know, oil washes and stuff over the top, and I love that.
Yeah, layering, well, it adds depth to the painting,
yeah.
too, you know. And,
absolutely.
Many times I'll go back and forth. I'll paint, and then I'll airbrush.
Yep.
And then sometimes, you know, things happen that you didn't plan on, you know.
True.
So, which is, I think, is what is, you know, the great fun thing about painting is the spontaneity of what you do. You
right.
know?
I like to see a lot of rhythm, and
mm-hmm.
I guess that's why I enjoy a lot of airbrush, you know,
yeah.
the softness and just the rhythm and the wispiness of it and stuff, so.
And the transparency, you can
yeah,
build transparent
layering.
Layers, and
yeah.
you also get the brilliance if you know, what I learned in school was, you know, a lot of the old masters, they used gesso.
Right.
But they used a white gesso, and that, you know, with a transparent airbrush or color, and you let that white come through, and it kind of, the light reflects and bounces off, and that's
of
what helps creates that depth.
Right.
I've always enjoyed doing mermaids, and you know, recently I've been kind of putting tattoos on them, and You know, back in the Maui and Sons days, I was one of the original founders of Maui and Sons, and we started doing sharks, and everyone loved the sharks, and then all of a sudden, that's all they wanted was sharks. Right. So
who hasn't? We kind of got doesn't know Maui and Sons?
Yeah,
you know, I remember drawing, because we couldn't afford even stickers back then, but I remember drawing the shark on my surfboard.
Oh, really?
You know, actually trying to draw and paint it on my surfboard and my skateboards, you know, all the time and stuff.
It's too bad we didn't know each other, because I could have sent you a bunch of stickers.
Man.
But anyway, so I'd always wanted to do a shark version of mermaid. So this one I call Shark Queen. She's got the shark tail.
Okay.
And anyway, I'm doing a series of mermaids also. This one I call Stormy.
I love that piece.
With the and then I've got a little bit of the pirate vibe going on with this, and I hit the skulls and the clouds. I always like to hide imagery in my paintings.
That is incredible.
And
Well, geez, I'm going to have to probably get one of these from you. But I did see a mermaid, I think, right behind your thing.
Hey, wait a minute.
The hands of the cookie jar.
A guy downstairs from the building, as a roofer, saw my truck and asked me about it. And I painted on the inside of the back of the bed. I did some graphics and used some one-shot paint and painted on the back. And so he was asking me about it, and he said he just bought an old 72, which is like the Scooby-Doo van.
Exactly.
And so he wanted to do, he wanted to paint a bright orange, and he wanted to do some cool graphics on it, and he wanted to do like lime green shag carpet inside, and just have fun with it,
Oh, after seeing the pictures, I was immediately excited. I said, oh, yeah. Bubble window, man, 70s man, let's do this. This looks great.
So he said, can you do that kind of thing? And I said, well, I've done some, but it's not really my main thing, And I said, well, give me some pictures of it and I'll color it up on the computer and I'll put some of my imagery on it and see if you like it, So I,
very cool.
I got some of my, I took one of my wave paintings and then I took one of my mermaids and I kind of put it all together on there and, he was pretty jazzed about it, and he said, "Well, how much?" And I was like, "I don't know how much to charge for something like that. I know what my paintings are worth." And
I do have a guy that you can call. He's by the name of Craig Frazier.
Oh yeah,
he's about the guru when it comes to hey, how much for this? How much for that? Really? In the automotive industry, that's for sure.
I should get him as my agent, probably. Then.
This is great, man. Taking a look inside where you're actually painting stuff. You mind if we take a look around your studio and check out some of the other artwork?
Yeah,
let's do it. Let's check it out. Come on. Wow, this is great. This has been great, Rick. This has been a really, really cool to come down. Hey, thanks a lot for having us. And I look forward to working with you on the van project in a couple weeks.
Me too. I'm excited about it. Yeah.
All right.
Can't wait.
Well, take care, man. We'll get together and go surfing sometime.
Sounds good. I'm ready anytime you are.
Thanks a lot.